Today I'm going to show you guys how to make this really cool and neat wallpaper for your phone in Adobe Illustrator. You can use your logo or your designs to use as a focal point of this vector wallpaper and save and upload it to use on your phone. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. So today I'm going to show you guys how to make this really neat wallpaper for your phone using vector techniques in Adobe Illustrator. I'm going to show you guys how to take your logo or your designs and desaturate them to a gray scale in Adobe Illustrator to use as the focal point for this design. This design looks very, very neat and it uses neon effects as well as stroke styles. So stay tuned and follow along in today's tutorial on how to design this neat wallpaper for your phone in Adobe Illustrator. Also, in the video, I'm going to reveal the two winners on my Clipper Mask Challenge giveaway. I really enjoy looking over the entries, and it's really cool to see all of the different styles and ideas that you guys have for using techniques in Adobe Illustrator. I think in about 1 or 2 weeks, I'm going to launch my big giveaway celebrating the 25,000 subscriber mark on this channel. It's a great way for me to say thank you to you guys for constantly tuning in, liking, commenting, and sharing my content here at Satori Graphics. I'm going to link this website in the description below, but it shows you all the screen dimensions in pixels for various smartphone models. This will help you decide what size to make your document to design a smartphone wallpaper using your logo. I'm going to use the iPhone X as today's example. So in Illustrator, create a new document and then select Web. We want the PPI to be 72, and we want to use pixels as the measurement. Make sure it's in portrait and then type in the correct dimensions for your smartphone model. Using a gradient fill, press M to access the rectangle tool and then create a shape over the entire canvas, being very careful to make sure it touches the edges of your smartphone wallpaper. The gradient we're going to use in today's tutorial needs to be a radial instead of linear gradient. And then you need to set both sides of the slider to this very dark blue here. Then you can adjust one side to be slightly darker in the RGB settings. When I was designing this gradient, there was no banding on my screen. But after recording, the software has caused the gradient to band a bit. However, I'm sure when I save it and then send it to my phone, there's going to be no banding on the gradient. Just make sure your design has a smooth gradient across the entire canvas. So once you've finished the gradient, lock it down in place so it doesn't move around for the remainder of this tutorial on how to make a smartphone wallpaper using your logo. Speaking of logo designs, here I have a different logo. If your logo has colour, then you can choose to keep it in full colour, but grayscale is going to work a lot better for this design. So with the logo design selected, go up to Edit, Edit Colours, and then choose Grayscale. Once you've done that, you can then go in and change the hue of grey on your design so it can be as bright as possible. You want it to pop off the background of the wallpaper for your smartphone. My logo is white however, so I don't need to adjust the colour settings. Place your logo on top of the smartphone wallpaper and then adjust it to your liking. We're now going to add an outer glow, so go up to Effect, Stylize and Outer Glow. You have to play around with these settings here, but we want to give a very subtle outer glow effect, not something that's too overpowering at this stage. I use soft light as the blend mode, a light blue colour, 95% opacity, and an 80% blur. With a white stroke selected, press P to locate the pen tool and then carefully hold down Shift to draw a line right across the wallpaper from left to right. You can then increase the stroke weight and elect to use a different stroke style. If we're going to make this line look super neat for our smartphone wallpaper design. So we're going to add an outer glow. This time the blend mode needs to be normal, so it has more presence on your design. We need to change the blend mode of the entire line, which we can do in the transparency window. You can locate this in the toolbar or you can go up to the window panel. Change the blend mode to overlay, and then hold down the Alt Option key to duplicate the line like so. You can then simply press Command or Control D over and over again to duplicate the line downwards. Finally, to make sure your lines are aligned perfectly, select them all and then align them in the Align window. Then all you need to do is to move them centrally onto your smartphone wallpaper design. We're now going to add the artistic finishing touches of our design. Firstly, you can select each line and increase or decrease the stroke weight. This will cause the lines to be more or less dominant on your design. You can also press Shift W to locate the width tool, and then you can increase or decrease the stroke weight anywhere along the line like so. I want you all to experiment and play with these techniques to design your smartphone wallpaper, so have fun and get creative with it. Oh, you can also copy a line with Control or Command C, and then you can press Command or Control F to paste it exactly in place. This will create a brighter line, as there's now going to be two lines on top of each other. So yeah, get creative and design your smartphone wallpaper until you feel it's finished. So once it's ready, you're going to need to save it for your smartphone. So go up to File and then use the Export and Save Web option. I feel that PNG would be best, but you can also use JPEG as a file format. Make sure not to check the transparency background option and then click Save. You can then move this over to your phone and set it to your wallpaper. And if you want, take a screenshot of your wallpaper and then upload it to Twitter or Instagram, and then you can tag Satori Graphics. I'd love to see your designs and what you come up with. So there is today's tutorial on how to design this neat wallpaper in Adobe Illustrator for your phone. Let me know what you guys thought of this video in the comment section below, and drop a like if you did enjoy it. Also, if you find my content useful, maybe share it on social media for other people to see. Now, I'm going to reveal the two winners of my challenge giveaway on using clipping masks in Adobe Illustrator. Thank you to everyone who submitted an entry into the challenge. I really did enjoy looking through all of your work and seeing different perspectives and ideas that you guys have. So last week I started a competition for you guys to design something using a clipping mask, and you all sent me very unique and very cool designs. That made my job pretty hard to decide a winner, because each design was so different and creative. I set a competition up on Twitter and Instagram, so thank you everyone who sent in your designs. I'm going to hold a bigger giveaway later this month when this channel hits 25,000 subscribers. So anyway, the first winner is the creator of this design here. I like this a lot because it's very simple, it's creative, and also the process was shown. So congratulations, I'm going to message you soon. The second winner is this entry here. I like the color choices and the layout of this design. So again, congratulations, and I'm going to be in touch very soon and send you your prizes. So thanks again to everyone who entered this competition. All the designs were unique and great in their own way. I'm going to be back tomorrow, so until then, design your future today. Peace.